over the years, I've met so many people who have asked me, were you born this way? Did you always know you wanted to be an entrepreneur? And I've thought a lot about it, and it just wasn't really even what I thought I was going to do. I didn't think I wasn't going to do it either. But I think that more than anything, what I've realized is that entrepreneurism can come from, you know, anywhere. You could be born with it. You could sort of decide that you never want to work for anyone. I've met those entrepreneurs as well. But for me, my road to being an entrepreneur was really seeing this problem that I had with my health. And I had a solution that I sort of stumbled upon just in trying to solve this health issue. And I was a tech executive. I actually was a journalism major with a minor in finance and started my career at Time magazine and ended up getting recruited out of there to a late stage startup that is funny for me to even talk about it that way, that everybody knows now, called CNN. So I was there in the very, very early days. And then came to Silicon Valley from New York, not really, again, I didn't, like a lot of other people, have this bug to go and be in a startup or anything like that, but I was somewhat fascinated by what Steve Jobs had done and what I had seen him do. And so I had looked up kind of a startup that I'd spun out of Apple, because I thought, they're never going to hire me at Apple because I don't have any experience. That was probably one of my first big doubts that I had, thinking that they'll never be interested in me because I don't really have the right experience. Anyway, I went and worked for a startup. We ended up getting acquired. That startup that I had, that I cold called, that was five guys, and not in a garage, but in a very small office. And America Online acquired us about 6 months after I got there. And that's when I, you know, really, I think, kind of established myself in tech. And I was the youngest vice president at AOL, one of the few women at sort of my level. And it was a wild ride. I went through what's termed a hockey stick, you know, of a company. And then it sort of leveled off after about 6 years, the growth around e-commerce. So it was like nothing when I got there until it was over $1 billion in revenue. And still didn't say I was going to leave and go start my own thing. It was when I was taking a couple years off in San Francisco. I had three young kids at the time, and really tried to test this idea around fixing my own health. I tried a number of diets. I was looking at ingredients for the first time. And I was primarily looking at ingredients in food and never really had looked at ingredients in my water, or eventually water, but my drink. And that's when I really just decided just to do a test to see what would happen and swap out my diet soda, Diet Coke in particular, for plain water. And I couldn't believe that I lost in 2.5 weeks, I lost 24 pounds and my acne cleared up. My energy levels were different. And I mean, it was crazy. And I think that's when I really had an epiphany, thinking, I always knew that water was better for me, but water just is boring. And some people really like it a lot, but I just didn't. I was honest with myself about the reason why. And that's when I thought, I wonder if I just throw a slice of cucumber or raspberries in there, if that will actually change the situation for me. And that's what I did in my kitchen.